Akia kanye hi ni kanye se sinye moti ka tawo boe ni anabo she ave besan ne kenke besan ikure anya na afi babawo ne wo mankralo e eshin wote ni lenche enye efe ni bi ni lenche sumo jase efoni ni echele be babawo she ebo wote ne ba hun wo ke yemo ton ewekunu panu koni achele ni eba nu otashi koni no ni gba awo na nu oke fun eyin no hun ebo oto ewekunu pa hun ebo le to e na gbe mo na kedan ya han ake shin achuke dan kete ake o ni mankralo won tabu pe mo ni eke wote osu police station ni wa je po ya cantonment police station ni wole no ni wo fe ni no iwo ni icho wo ya police station ti mo nu wote e yue mo nu wa nu eji eke wo ke wo ba pale na nu kwale ke obi ke an ba pa bo e je police station ayo na kansani e nu o police fu e na ke sani e ni ke ba je je ma ayo na kansani e nu o ake ewe kunu pa ko ni chele na tobi na pe no una chele eke eba kokoko shin leji mankralo no ni esumo ni ba fe wo wuro mogbo wo ye kusun ni ke wuro mogbo e na fi o ni wuro mogbo e ewo le ato ni mammu fe n ta wo wuro mo he ni yo keke na cho gbeje anu to papa no na to ato wuro mo bo na fe ni muji ku akaba mami fi nyo jete wuro mo weku me eweku nu pa fe te fe ebo mukumoko to e wona ke neto iya ke ba bule ma be ma nu e ba bule no ja si e pe ni ja si e fe ko me wona bu te odoro ben ko me mi ake no ni wo yitu e fi o bi ane wo chuko e gbramo mi an yitu e poto mo nu e ba poto no esa nu wo fu o yitu e wona fe ni wo ta yitu kokro ko ni ma ana imama papa e ko ni ebu nu ogmene wo pe nu wo ba pe e bi e be wo mankralo pamo e wo ba pe e bi e nu wo pale nu wo fi ekusun ehun pepepe nu wo wojin nu wo kani e ke nya asumo ma kani e blofu e mi hun ma han yo destoolment of Nii Ako Nortei the second of fourth as Osu Mantse Osu Mankralo Nimei Name, distinguished guests, representatives of the print and news media, welcome to this very important gathering in the history of Osu Ashente Jaase today, 30th December 2016. We are gathered here today to perform a rite that is a very remarkable stage in the history of the people of Osu Ashente Quarter. Osu is made up of four quarters, to wit Osu Kinkawe, Osu Ashante Blohun, Osu Anoho, and Osu Alata. These quarters have their own Jaase responsible for matters concerning traditional office holdings and are therefore independent in their own rights and capacities. Flowing from the above, it is expedient to expound the rights and powers of the Osu Ashante Blohun Jaase. Osu Ashante Blohun Jaase. This is the highest and only traditional cabinet the people of Osu Ashante Blohun, which has the power to install or destool a mankralo for Osu and its Jaase and other Ashante. Proudly to say that Osu was the first Ghana state to create a mankralo stool along the coast from Ada to Winneba. Of late, the Osu Ashante Blohun Jaase has been worried at the behavior and activities of its mankralo in the person of Nii Ako Nortei IV, known in private life as Samuel Okwei Nortei. He has arrogated to himself autocratic powers that are averse to lorical norms and tenets of the Osu Ashante Blohun Quarter. He has persistently refused to attend to invitations from the Jaase, which made him the mankralo, to call him to attention on very grievous matters that has gone to create dichotomy in the whole of Osu. It is imperative that we enumerate a few of his numerous atrocities he has committed against the people of Osu. Samuel Okwei Nortei as Osu Mankralo. Though Osu has a sitting manche in the person of Nii Nortey Owuo III, Nii Mankralo raised himself to the autocratic position of acting Osu Manche without rights or custom, just to be able to sell Osu lands. In failure to the above pursuit, he single-handedly, in authority, formed a quasi jase and nominated, selected, and installed a total stranger, Michael Kwatelai Owu, a.k.a. Nii Okwei Kinka Dowuona VI, as Osu Manche to perpetrate his heinous crime against the state of Osu. He was consequently dragged to court by the incumbent Osu Manche and was found guilty in a contempt case and sentenced to a fine of 5,000 Ghana cedis in the High Court presided over by his lordship, J.F. Japasu. In spite of a long-standing oath in matters concerning the Osu Ashente Jaase stool, Nii Mankralo single-handedly nominated, elected, and installed as Jaase chair from the same house as the incumbent Jaase chair, Nii Omato VI, who is still alive and on the stool, creating a fatal dichotomy in that royal family. In spite of the fact that the Supreme Court of Ghana in its judgment in a matter between Osu Stool, acting per its lawful attorney, Nii Ako Nortei II, Osu Mankralo, versus Unilever Ghana Limited, in which Nii Nortey Owuo III, Osu Manche, was the intervener, on 17th May 2006, clearly indicated that the Osu Stool is not vacant, the emphasis mine. Nii Ako Nortei, in his greed and atrocious motive, nominated and selected and stood a total stranger, Michael Kwatelai Owu, as Nii Kinka Dowuona VI, who hails from Fase in the Gangbese division. In this matter, Nii Ako Nortei VI has been the protagonist and has since been in the front row of matters for the imposter Manche in the sale of Osu properties, especially after helping this imposter to secure a fraudulent gazette which is currently before the Supreme Court of Ghana for judgment. Let us consider the position of the Supreme Court of Ghana on gazettes. The Supreme Court, speaking with one voice, stated in Republic versus National House of Chiefs, ex parte Akrofa Kukroko II, in bracket Enimil VI, interested party, Ghana Law Report 2007-2008, SCGLR 173. Sophia Adinira, JSC, reading the unanimous verdict of the court, stated as follows. It is settled law that entries made or deleted from the National House of Chiefs do not constitute adjudication or determination as to who is a chief or who is not, but rather a purely administrative act. In contradiction to the tenets and discipline of his office as Mankralo, he keeps being inconsistent in charges brought against him and his imposter chief at the Greater Accra Regional House of Chiefs Tribunal at Dodoa. To add salt to injury, Nii Ako Nortei IV grossly flouted existing austere religious rites about the burial of the Osu State Romo on his demise. To say the least, he sacrilegiously, as he is wont to do, disregarded the call of Osu Ashente Jaase to follow laid down principles to perform the burial rites. He obnoxiously disregarded the family head and family of the late Wuromo and buried him without the consent of the family and the Osu Ashente Jaase, which installed the Wuromo. Flowing from the above grievous atrocities, the Osu Ashente Jaase extended several invitations to him through his family head to a meeting to settle the impasse. But Nii Ako Nortei, the Osu Mankralo, upon receiving the invitation, reported the Osu Ashente Jaase to the police for no discernible reason. The police command at cantonments, upon hearing the statement of the representatives of the Jaase, directed that the Akonwe family head in the person of Nii Ate Agbawe convene a meeting between the Jaase and Nii Ako Nortei to resolve the impasse amicably. Nii Ako Nortei IV recalcitrantly, in an arrogant statement through his family head, averred that he will never, and I repeat, never sit in a meeting with the Osu Ashente Jaase. To this end, the Osu Ashente Jaase resolved in a declaration to destool him as the Osu Mankralo. So, distinguished guests, Nime, Name, respected representatives of the media, this is the a priori of today's action by the Osu Ashente Jaase. Thank you all for coming. Wow. I am Nii Noi Osekan Peneku IV, the Shipidudo of Osu and acting Klote Wulo.
Okay.
I'm Nii Nortey Owuo VI. I was installed in 1976 by the late Nii Nortey Owuo II. And I acted as Mankralo of Osu from 1983 to 1985. And I'm still the Jaase Chair of Osu Ashante Jaase.
Okay, so the question is, what then makes you the legitimate counsel or, you know, elders to then these two, the Osu Mankralo?
The Mankralo knows the Jaase of Osu Ashante Jaase. And therefore, as we are sitting down here, I have the authority to say something about him. And I appointed the Shipi Nii Noi Sekan Peneku IV as the leader of the Jaase to take the action we are taking today.
And per Osu custom, is the Jaase the rightful, you know, counsel to these two Osu Mankralo, is it?
Yes. Yes. He was installed on the stool here, the stool behind your photographer. And we have performed everything to destool him here today.
But here is a case where you in particular, Nii Ako Nortei, doesn't even recognize you as the legitimate Jaase Chair. For he recognizes someone else as the Jaase Chair. So your legitimacy as the Jaase Chair is even in question.
Really, as you are saying, you are right. But I want to tell you that all the Jaase members around know that I am the Jaase Chair of Osu Ashante Jaase. And even the other quarters, Kinkawe, Alata, Anoho, they all know me as the Jaase Chair of Osu Ashante Jaase.
Okay. So my last question is the fact that you appear to be playing the traditional politics style where we see Ako Nortei with the one you claim to be Nii Nortey Owuo, that is Nii Okwei Kinka Dowuona, Nii Okwei Kinka Dowuona. And you are usually seen with Nii Nortey Owuo, and as such, you want to get him off the scene and then have your own way. Isn't it what we are seeing?
No, that is not what you are saying. And if you are saying it that way, Okwei Kinka is not a legitimate manche of Osu, and therefore the Mankralo does not have that right to even move with him. And that is the reason why the Osu Ashente Jaase, which stooled him as the Mankralo, called him to book, and he has refused to listen to us. That is why we have destooled him.
You are dividing Osu.
We are not.
By your actions, today that, tomorrow that, blah, blah, blah. It doesn't talk out well for the image of your own community.
Osu, we are not dividing Osu. Osu has been divided by the Mankralo we have destooled today. So we are trying to destool him and then bring unity to Osu. Yeah. He was installed on the in the stool room here in this very house, the stool room behind the photographer. So the rites that we performed to install him has been reversed in the same stool room. So we have done that. We slaughtered a ram and fired a musket to signify that he has been destooled. And when one is being installed, he could be forced, he could be caught and forced to be installed. And when he is being destooled too, he could be caught and all the beads and other things removed from him. And we call some, at times we see that as an assault. Therefore, we performed the rites that makes him a Mankralo, and we performed the rites that destooled him.
Okay, in this same instance, my last question, it could be that you were being cunning on Nii Ako Nortei, for which you claim to have sent him several, invites to meet you. Perhaps your intention was to have him with you, then you used that to then destool him. Isn't that the case, or wasn't that the case?
That was not our intention. Our intention was to call him, tell him what exactly he is doing that the Jaase and the state do not like, and he failed to come. So the Jaase have resolved to destool him on several occasions. In pouring the libation, we stated that if he stands on any platform as Osu Mankralo, we shall deal with him. And if he calls himself as Osu Mankralo, we shall deal with him. And we have warned the whole world at large not to recognize him as Osu Mankralo. And if he does that, we'll deal with him traditionally and legally.